People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Serpy. Now the ongoing race for the PNP presidency, I get hot like when you buck off your toe. Because Peter Bunting has decided to step out on the front foot and is now seemingly throwing all kind of jabs, right, to stake his claim as the rightful leader of the party. But Bunting has done something that, as well, I shouldn't really be that surprised, but nevertheless, it's a bold move. I'm going to tell you why I'm not surprised later on in the video. Bunting's team has basically come out and styled certain people who are supporting Peter Phillips' One PNP campaign as old, washed-up dons. Now, if you remember, a couple days ago, Sunday, when I made a video showing you that Skengdon and Danai Williams were publicly in support of Peter Phillips. They were wearing his One PNP shirts. They were on the road with him, right? As you can see in this picture there, they're boldly declaring which side they might take. So when you hear Peter Bunting come out and say, Peter Phillips, I try to use old washed up dons, guess who he's talking about? He doesn't have to call any names. He's clearly talking about Skengdon and Peter Phillips. Sorry, I mean Skengdon and Danai Williams. Right? And there has been talk in the streets for a good while now that all the 90 octanes are backing Phillips, right? So when I saw Danai and Skengdon at a rally in support of Phillips, I realized this is true, because Skengdon and Danai are so influential in the party that a lot of the other smaller 90 octanes, when them see man like them and they come out and back Phillips, they might go back Phillips too, right? But the fact that Peter Bunting has come out and has come out so, as that meme says, come out and deal Peter Phillips as strong, that shows me that Peter Bunting has come to the conclusion that he is now at a point in his career where he doesn't need any of these men. He's at a point in his career when he doesn't need people like Skengdon to back him and give him the money or give him the support. And as I said before, I've said it many times, this is what happens when you're dealing with a politician who have them own money, right? Because Bunting pockets are very heavy. Bunting is independently wealthy. He don't really need to call upon sponsors and donors like that, right? He's probably running this campaign mostly from out of his pocket. Plus, he have other people around him like Mark Golding, who are also pretty successful. So, Bunting has no hesitation rejecting certain people. But what is surprising to me was the fact that he called out Skengdon too. See, Danai Williams is not a surprise to me now. Because Danai Williams are really town man, right? But remember, Bunting is the MP from Manchester. I think it's Central Manchester, if I'm not mistaken, right? And as you know, Skengdon is the big man down in Manchester, or as Teddy Brookshott said, at least him once was, yeah? Because clearly, Bunting is the new Dan. A matter of fact, for the rest of this video, we're not even going to call him Peter Bunting anymore. We're not going to call him Peter Banton, because clearly him depends on some rude boy thing. Now, let me just say this out there before I go any further. All the supporters of Peter Bunting, all the PNP who support Bunting, please do not go around publicly referring to Skengdon or Danai Williams as old washed up dance, especially if you come from out of East Kingston or come from anywhere down in Manchester or St. Elizabeth, that side. Please, Peter Bunting can do this and say this and get away with it, right? I don't think you will be as lucky, right? Even though they do not wield the same amount of power they did back in the day, they still have enough 87s around them who can do some serious damage, right? So please, nobody walk up and down on the road and make too much people area call Skengdan or Danai old and washed up, right? That's just for your own safety, right? Now back to what I was saying. Now, Bunting also went as far as to call out the vote buying allegations. Now, of course, I did a video on that, and as far as I'm concerned, that clearly was an attempt to buy votes, right? So I don't know what Bunting is talking about. In my opinion, that was a clear attempt to buy votes, right? But what is going to happen next? We're 2 days away from the decision who is going to become the leader of the PNP, right? So now, when people come out and take sides like this, because it's not just the fact that Skengdan and Danai and so much of the 90 Actians back Phillips, you know. Now that Bunting has come out and say, yo, basically them man they are fool. Them man they wash up, them time done. What I want to know is, what is going to happen on the 8th of September? Because the election is the 7th. What is going to happen on the 8th? Because remember, once the leader is decided, it's going to become one PNP again. Even if it's not Peter Phillips, one PNP win it, right? But they're going to become a single party with a single leader now, and they're going to have to show some kind of united front. So if Bunting come out and say basically them done the old and washed up, and it's basically running them away, are those done still going to support the party if Peter Bunting win? Of course they are. Come on, people. What were you thinking? Of course they are. Because they're not ashamed. They're not... Listen, Peter Bunting can call them anything you want to call him. If he becomes leader, they will support him. And they will try to become his friend. Because they want to make sure that if him win the next general election and him get back in power, he will be able to help them out and sort them out with certain favors. This is how these men get and stay wealthy, right? By getting certain political contracts and getting certain political links, and their politician friend help them get away from certain cases, right? As protege say, real bad man negotiation, right? The reason why you're not a station is because you're a politician friend. You're a very senior politician friend. So you need that politician on your side. So even though you hear Bunting style up these old washed up dance, if Bunting wins, you best believe it, all those old washed up dance will be trying to become his friend. But I hope Bunting stay true to his word. I hope he's not just saying this because they're not taking theme side. Because what would be, you know what would be an extraordinary move? If Skengdan and Danai had decided to take Bunting's side, and then Bunting said, no, I don't want your support. I don't want to stand beside of me. For me, that would be one of the single biggest symbolic statements any politician could make. And that alone would make Bunting deserve to become the leader of the PNP. Let me clear this up again. If Skengdan and Danai had take Bunting's side and Bunting come out and said, no, I don't want the support of these old washed up dance. I don't want no man of these allegations attached to them standing next to me. Just for that alone, I think Bunting would deserve to become the leader of the PNP. But at the moment, we don't know if this is a case of the fox saying it's sour because he can't reach it, because them take Phillip's side. So it's easy for him to say that. Nevertheless, people, we're 2 days away. Whatever happens, it's going to be very interesting. I tell you already. as far as I'm concerned, if Peter Phillips win and remain the president of the PNP, Andrew Holness, I go deal with him rush in the next general election. He will lose to Andrew Holness. Bunting reduces the odds of losing, right? In my opinion, it gives the PNP a better chance, but he's probably still going to lose as well. But you never know. It's at least more competitive with Bunting at the head, right? But let's see how it play out now. PHN squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless up.